Hello and welcome to Wheels on the Bike. I'm Agnieszka. In this video, I'm going to share with you my thoughts on the Brooks B17 saddles. I have two of them, B17S or short, and B17, the Champion Standard. I'll share with you my thoughts, the pros and cons, what I like, what I dislike about them, and I will also share with you a tip that I found useful for braking in the saddle quicker. So if you're interested in any of that, then keep watching. All right, Brooks B17 saddles. They are leather saddles. They're handmade, and because of that, they come with a bit of a price tag. They were designed to support a more upright riding position, and they're good for anyone who is commuting, bicycle touring, and doing some light gravel riding. Because they are leather, they do require a bit of a break-in at the beginning, but over time, they will shape themselves to your anatomy and become very comfortable. But because they are leather, they do require some maintenance, some conditioning, and some tensioning. Additionally, they are not waterproof. Brooks B17 saddles are very polarizing. Some people love them, some people hate them. And I fall kind of on either side of the spectrum, depending on which saddle we're talking about. So one of these saddles I really enjoy riding on, one of these saddles, not so much. So if you want to know which one is which, then stay with me. This is the B17S or short, and this is the Lady Standard. This is the very first saddle that I bought, and I've had it at this point for over a year. I have it installed on my commuter bicycle, and I have it in the color black. In comparison to the regular or the Champion Standard saddle, this one is about 1.3 inches shorter, which is quite considerable. Additionally, the rails are a bit shorter as well. And this is my second Brooks B17 saddle. This is the B17 Champion Standard. I've had this saddle now for just over 4 months. It came stock with my Kona Sutra touring bicycle, so technically speaking, I didn't outright buy it. This saddle is in the color honey. And because it's still relatively new, I think this saddle is still very much at the breaking in period. I have been doing something different to break it in, and I will be sharing that tip later on in the video. So to compare the two saddles, this is the length difference. I already mentioned that there is a difference in the rails between them. Before we jump into the pros and cons of the saddles, I wanted to address one thing, specifically saddle maintenance. So to me, saddle maintenance is neither pro nor con, it's something that needs to be done. So having to apply proof hide every 4 to 6 months or as needed is not a big deal. Same with tensioning of the saddle. So this little spanner or a wrench comes included with the saddle when you purchase it. And having to adjust the saddle again when you think it needs to be adjusted is just part of bicycle maintenance. And on to the pros. For me, the saddles were pretty comfortable right out of the box. They were on the hard side, absolutely, and they were quite slippery, and I actually didn't enjoy them being so slippery. I know some people tilt the saddle up to prevent them from slipping forward. I didn't do that. I just kept the saddle level. And eventually that feeling of them being slippery went away the more I rode them. I did mention that I've been doing something different with this saddle to break it in, and that is I've been applying proof hide to it a lot more frequently than Brooks recommends. So in the first week, I applied proof hide to this area every single day. And then since then, I've been applying it a lot more frequently, and I feel like in comparison to the other saddle, this saddle has been breaking in a lot quicker and it's becoming a lot more comfortable quicker. The second pro of the saddles is that the more I ride them, the more comfortable they become. The more the leather breaks in, the more comfortable the saddle becomes. The third pro for me is that I don't have to wear padded shorts. Now, I have this saddle on a commuter bike, I have this saddle on the touring bike, and I don't necessarily want to have to wear padded shorts when I ride around town or when I go on tour. I can if I want to, and if I don't want to, I don't have to. And that for me is a big pro. As with anything, there are cons. So what are my cons about these saddles? Because these are leather, they are not waterproof. They are water resistant, especially with application of proof hide, but they are not waterproof. And you will notice on this saddle specifically there is some water damage right along the edges of the saddle. And that's because I got a little bit sloppy in application of proof height. So note to self, make sure when you're applying proof height or any other leather conditioning agent that you focus on the edges as well, because I think in my haste I just focused kind of on this area on the underside, but I forgot about the edges and the saddle now has some water stains on them, so not great. But what I do to protect the saddle when I know that I will leave the bike outside when it rains, I carry a lot of these shower caps with me. And I have them in multiple of my bags, and whenever I leave, I just place the shower cap over my bicycle seat. The shower cap, because it is clear, is not going to protect the saddle from the sun rays, so if you want that, you just need to choose something more opaque. Brooks themselves sell seat covers or saddle covers, so if you want to make an additional investment to protect your saddle, you can do that as well. The second con for me is, because the saddles are leather, they are a little bit easier to damage. And the previous experience I've had with bike saddles has been with synthetic saddles. So I often just flip the bike over to do some mechanical work on it. And I had done that with this saddle as well. And you will notice that right on the edges here, there is some damage, or there are some impressions where I had damaged the saddle by placing it on a bit of cement. So just keep that in mind. If you're leaning your bike against an abrasive surface, or if you're flipping your bike over to do some mechanical work, just place maybe a rag or place a tissue between the saddle and the abrasive surface, and you will be fine. The third con I have about the Brooks B17 saddles is short rails. Specifically on the B17S saddle or the women's saddle, the short rails are actually posing a bit of a problem in that I cannot adjust this saddle to the best fit for me on my bicycle, my commuter bicycle. And that's what makes this saddle a little bit uncomfortable. So if you are purchasing, if you're thinking of getting this Brooks B17S or short saddle, then keep that in mind. You may not have enough space on the rails to be able to adjust this saddle on your bicycle. So which of these two is my favorite, or which of these two do I find most comfortable? And I think you already may know this one. The Brooks B17 Champion Standard is the saddle that I find most comfortable. It is a bit longer, the rails are longer, and it's easier to adjust on the bike. As well, because I've been applying proof hide right from the get-go, I think that it's in itself made a huge difference in breaking the saddle in. As well, being able to have that additional saddle real estate has allowed me to just better position myself on the bike as I ride. Just bear in mind that everything that I've shared in this video is based on my personal preferences, my riding style, and my experiences with the Brooks B17 saddles. Saddles are very personal. What I may like, you may not like, and vice versa. So keep that in mind. Before I sign off, I want to give a quick shout out to Gaia. Gaia is a new subscriber with whom I connected on somebody else's channel. Gaia shared with me a great post about female anatomy and saddles, and I'm going to include the link to that post in the description below. So if you are a female rider, you may be interested in reading more about the topic. Okay. Thank you very much for watching this video. I appreciate your time. I would love to know from you. Do you ride B17 saddles? Do you like them? Do you not like them? Have they worked out for you? Have they not worked out for you, and why? Or do you ride any other leather saddles? I know there's other leather saddle makers out there. And I would love to know, I would love to hear your experiences. So if you'd like to share, please do in the comments below. Additionally, comment, like, share, subscribe, do all the YouTube things. This is a new channel that is growing, and I would love your support. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.